An important sentence about thermal expansion is that when the body expands, it is like moving in or magnifying the body. That is, every part of the body expands. Okay. So what does this mean? Suppose that there was a disc plate with a tiny hole at center. Suppose there was a disc with a tiny hole at center. And now if we heat it, then the hole also gets bigger due to heating. Did you understand this? What do I mean? There's a hole here. Okay, and if you heat this entire thing, so not only the diameter of disc will increase, but also the diameter of hole will increase. So it's just like as if you are watching it from far, and now like you zoom into photographs. Now what is it? So if you zoom into this photograph, what will happen? Even the hole will appear bigger. Right, so it's not that only this matter part expands, but overall the whole shape is going to expand. So whenever you have holes in such objects, when you heat, will the hole become larger or smaller? The answer is larger. When you heat this object, the hole also becomes larger. Clear? Okay, so this is the one thing that you need to know. Right? Fine. Now, I think we can go over to the next thing, and that is the specific heat. The next thing is specific heat. Now, what is specific heat? You have studied this in chemistry, I believe. Yes or no?
Yes.
Right. Okay. Specific heat is simply defined by a formula, right? Formula first. That way it is easy to understand what the formula is
or what specific heat is.
Symbol of specific heat is S.
Okay, symbol of specific heat is S.
So specific heat S is equal to heat supplied per unit mass per unit change of temperature.
Right? Specific heat S is the heat supplied per unit mass per unit change of temperature. So in words, this is how it works. The heat supplied to a body, heat supplied to a body for unit mass to raise its temperature, by 1 unit. So 1 unit, that would be like 1 degree Celsius or 1 Kelvin, because these are the units that we use for temperature. So heat supplied to a body per unit mass to raise its temperature by 1 unit, like 1 degree Celsius or 1 Kelvin, is called specific heat of that material. Okay. Not the body. Specific heat is a property of material. Right? So here, what are the terms? Q for heat, or heat supply, of course. Okay, m for mass of body and delta T for increase or change in temperature. So this is specific. Definitely give an example of all this. But one thing that I want you to understand upfront is that specific heat of a material, specific heat of a material, does not depend on mass. Specific heat of a material does not depend on it. Might look like this is totally wrong, this sentence. Okay, formula may be is Q of 1F delta T. Seems strange, doesn't it? Right? Okay, but this is still true. Why? It will come from eventually, right? Okay. So one thing that again start with while explaining this one is as follows. Suppose you say that force is equal to mass into acceleration. Let's say you apply some force on a body of mass m and you get an acceleration m. Then would it be right to say that the applied force depends on mass? If I say that you apply some force F on a body, let's say body's mass is M, so you get acceleration A for the body. Make sense? Then is it right to say that the applied force depends on mass M? Basically, I'm asking, let's say this is a chair. How much force I apply on that chair? Does it depend on its mass? Mara to zero force apply karo to karo. Clear or not clear? So why am I bringing that up? I'm trying to explain, just because M appears in the formula does not mean S depends on M. Does F depend on M here? No way. Actually, Mundu said A depends on F and M. A what? What A depends on F and M. Then Amayu, Q and delta T. Q and delta T, they will adjust everything in such a way that S will not depend on M. Right? Got the idea? Values here, they are in the typical way. Suppose, specifically, no water. I'm not so sure whether you are knowing it, but it's about 4.186 joule per gram. Are you aware of this? Or are you aware that this is equal to like 1 calorie per gram? So what does this mean? Okay, I will summarize it. But basically, everything will be. So suppose you take 1 gram of water. Very little volume. And let's say temperature is, for example, 10 degrees. And I want to heat it and make its temperature 11 degrees. 1 gram water. I mean, you want to go from 10 degrees Celsius to 11 degrees Celsius. Then how much is the this is actually calorie per gram per degree Celsius. Okay, calorie gram per degree Celsius, like that. So I want to increase it by 1 degree Celsius. Then how much heat is required is 4.186 joule for 1 gram. Again, this is the heat required for 1 gram, means unit mass to raise the temperature by 1 degree Celsius or by 1 Kelvin. However, suppose instead of 1 gram water, let's say instead of 1 gram water, you take 1 kg water. You understand that? Means you are taking how many times of water in the first case? 1000. Got it? So now, do you realize that if you take more water and you want to heat water from 10 to 11 degrees Celsius, it will definitely take more energy, correct or not? Absolutely. absolutely clear. So the answer is that it will take 1000 times more energy. Why 1000 times? Because earlier it took one drop water, now you are taking 1 kg. So you get what? 1000, you need 1000 times more energy. To do the same thing. Clear? To do the same thing. Make sense? Now, if you would change this even further, suppose you take 1 kg water again, but you don't want to change the temperature from 10 degrees Celsius to 11. You want to take it instead from 10 degrees Celsius to 20 degrees Celsius. Don't you think this will take more energy? Actually, 10 to 11, say it's garam garam. 10 to 20, more, isn't it? So, you want to change the temperature by 10 times. So here, the energy required will be 4,186,0. Does this make sense? Yes or no? Sure. So all this points out to one thing. Now, because for 1 gram water and 1 degree Celsius, the amount of energy required is 4.1. Based on that, you are getting things. Go further. Amazing this, okay? You can also think of it as follows. See, how much heat you need to supply should be proportional to mass, correct or not? What does that mean? The more mass you take, the more heat you will have to supply for same delta E. That is, if you compare two cases, in one case you take more mass, in one take you take less mass. So, where the mass is more, you need to supply more heat for getting the same delta. Energy. You proportional to delta T if you take the same mass of water. What do I mean? Let's say you take 1 kg water. You want to increase the temperature by 10 degrees Celsius. Then that takes some energy. But instead of 10 degrees Celsius, you want to increase the temperature, let's say by 100 degrees Celsius. That will take much more energy. Yes or no? Sure. Okay. So now if you combine both of these, you get this. Correct? And you know, whenever we see proportionality, we try to remove that proportionality. So, I should write some. So do you realize that constant should be nothing but specific? So it's basically that constant. Okay, what does that constant tell you? This constant E is equal to the heat supply per unit mass per unit change of temperature. Okay, so it's very simple. Right, so finally you can say that Q is equal to ms delta T. Generally, you can talk about everything else. Q equal to ms delta T, where S is a constant. And that constant is called specific heat. Right? Specific heat. What specific heat capacity? That's it. Fine. Okay. Again, specific heat does not depend on what? Mass. Right? Does not depend on mass. Kem evo kan ke mass vadhara hase to Q vadhara hase. That will get cancelled. So, what does specific heat depend on? You might ask. It doesn't depend on mass. It's a property of material. Specific heat S is a property of material. Okay? It's a property of material. It generally varies with temperature. It generally varies with temperature. But for simple calculations, we consider it to be constant. For simple calculations, we consider it to be constant. I hope you understand what we are doing. The S value actually temperature will depend. The value of S depends on temperature. Different temperatures, different at higher temperatures, the value of S increases for all substances. Right? So, please remember this. This I made for Atal Seta, the Okay? Okay, this water. So Q equal to MS delta T, very important formula. Again, this will also tell you about the unit. Currently basic formula. Joule per kg per Kelvin. SI unit of specific heat is joule per kg per Kelvin. Clear? Okay. So that's specific. Let's go to the next one. Now again then. So there is one specific heat that you need to remember, and that is of water. It's 4.186 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Please note what we have done. Pehla maine humne joule per gram maangi thi. Okay, this is kilojoule per kilogram. It's the same maza, right? Take from the secret code about this property. This property is nothing more than cross multiplication. This property is nothing more than cross multiplication. What do I mean? OMK is specific heat of water. Right? If you have got 10 kg water and you supply this much heat, then how much will be the increase in temperature? So finally, there's a problem of cross multiplication. Really, not kidding. Our formula. वगैरह बनता हम रहे हैं स्पेशली सपोज यू डोंट नो दिस यू कैन ऑलवेज डू मैं कितनी बार कर रही स्मार्ट कारण कि अच्छे जो प्रोपोर्शनलिटी आवे ने एक क्रॉस मल्टीप्लिकेशन था एज सिंपल एज दैट राइट ओके सो दैट्स अबाउट वाटर दिस इज टू बी रिमेंबर्ड Okay, this one you need to remember. DGA value yaad rakhvani zarur. Also, it's high time now that you understand what is 1 calorie. Calorie is another unit of energy and it is 1 calorie equal to 4.186 joule. Often we take 4.2 joule. How calculation marks? 30 is 21. 2 kilo. When you don't have calculator, it's very big from 4.186 joule. No. Okay? Approximately 4.2 we take in that the way I have a calorie. Well then, next one, heat capacity. Now what is our point? Chemistry heat capacity. How is that? It's different from the heat capacity, right? So what is heat capacity? Fill a definition. If it's a formula, heat capacity is generally capital S or sometimes capital C, but I would say we'll avoid capital C. And the capital C then APG goes to non-human, which is not very useful. Okay? That's right, capital S. Heat capacity equals Q by delta T, as simple as that. Q by delta T. So how do you say this in words? It is the heat supplied to a body for a unit change or rise. A unit rise or unit change in temperature. Heat supplied to a body for a unit rise in temperature, that is what 1 degree Celsius or 1 Kelvin is called heat capacity of that body, called heat capacity S of that body. See the difference. Coulomb's law also is a specific heat capacity of the material. Okay, but here it is the specific heat capacity of that body. Okay, right? And here is the note. Heat capacity of heat capacity depends on mass. Heat capacity depends on mass. Okay, on mass of body. वो पता ना चले. बराबर है. Heat capacity depends on mass of body. It's true. बोले हम मास का होते हैं. Still it depends on mass of body. Right? So let me give you an example. Okay, let's take our example further. Together, right? Translated के बोल तो ये तो क्या जब बता दें? तो हमने कौन पढ़े?
If Q ने वैल्यू सब्सटीट्यूट कर तो डेल्टा डिकेंस लगते
हैं. Q की वैल्यू? हाँ तो ये साची बात है. करवाना चाहिए आपने. Okay, we are going to do that. Okay, so. Let's go through the example first, then we'll do what sort of this suggestion, right?
Here's the example. Let's say you take, let's say, 1 gram water, and you want to increase its temperature from 10 degrees Celsius to 11 degrees. So this will need energy 4.186 joules, correct?
So this is 1 gram water, let's say, in some bucket, or in some
let's say in a small vessel,
right? Okay, so to increase the temperature of this thing, this 1 gram water by 1 degree Celsius, we need only this much energy, correct or not? So or any heat capacity, agree? The energy required to increase the temperature by 1 degree Celsius or 1 Kelvin for a particular body. So that amount of water is a what? But now suppose we take 1 kg water and you want to do the same thing. That is, you want to increase it from 10 degree Celsius to 11 degree Celsius. A 10-11 kind of example, you know, suppose you have 41-42 degrees. Now we will need 4186 joules. I hope that makes sense to you. Okay, what are water? Any heat capacity के लिए 1 kg water has how much heat capacity? 4186 joules. Because if you take 1 kg water, then you need this much energy to increase the temperature from 10 to 11 degrees by 1 degree. Clear or not clear? अभी बोला जैसे खांचो को बोलो heat capacity को body depend on mass. इतने बढ़ारे मास होए तो heat capacity बढ़ारे होगा. कुछ मान लेते हो चल, right? So let's see whether you have understood all this. Let's say in this vessel there is a little droplet of water 1 gram, and here the water is filled, and this is 1 kg water. Okay? Then the question is which has more capital S, that is which has more heat capacity, the water in vessel 1 or the water in vessel 2? Which has more heat capacity? Which has more heat capacity? Water in vessel 1 or vessel 2? Confidence, you know, Jordan.
Vessel 2.
Sure. Has more heat capacity. Okay. Fine, that's correct. It is the vessel number 2. Now the next question. Which has more specific heat capacity?
That's right.
Both have same specification because both are water. Is it clear or not clear? Assuming that you know temperature is same and for that so doesn't vary with temperature. Understood? So please be careful about all this. Right? So we solve together. You see that if we quote the formula of Q from the previous discussion, instead of Q I can write m small s delta T, isn't it? Right? That is Q equal to ms delta T, where S is specific heat. So capital S equal to ms. Capital S equal to ms. Right? So this again clearly goes on to show this. Remember then, what heat capacity of the body depends on mass. Small s, that is specific heat capacity, is a constant of material. It is a change on that. capital S displacement zone. Understood? Okay. Right. Now, just one thing. Suppose instead of supplying heat, you remove heat, then temperature will decrease. Clear? So, if what is the same? Only that, only as follows. When heat is supplied to the body, heat is supplied to the body, we consider Q is greater than 0. Okay, heat supplied to the body, that means we consider Q is greater than 0. And heat removed from the body. Samjhaya? Heat removed from the body, we say that Q is less than 0. Actually, we have studied this in chemistry as well, in thermodynamics. Right? Abhudvi, Chalu, thank you, Shavu. Dire, dire. Understood this? Okay. So, one thing that I forgot to let you, capital F to unit to all this.
Joule
per Kelvin. SI unit. Joule per Kelvin. Easy to remember. Mundo, yaad is not a fact. Formula, yaad apan hi chain over to some, to me person. फॉर्मूला जो इन्हें खबर पड़ी करेक्ट ओके सो टू इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला है वन स्पेसिफिक हीट एट क्यू इक्वल टू एमएस डेल्टा टी एंड एस इक्वल टू क्यू बाय एम डेल्टा यू हैव चॉइस ऑफ राइट चॉइस व्हाट व्हिच एवर यू सेकंड वन दिस वन एस इक्वल टू कैपिटल एस मींस हीट कैपेसिटी ऑफ बॉडी इज क्यू अपॉन एस डेल्टा અને એ બોલ રિલેટેડ બે કેપિટલ એસ ઇક્વલ ટુ એમ એસ અને આ એક બે નાના નાના સેન્ટર રાઈટ ઓકે નાવ લેટ ગો ટુ ધ નેક્સ્ટ હજી એક મોલર હીટ કેપેસિટી હોય બટ આઈ એમ નોટ ગોઈંગ ટુ ટીચ યુ દેટ રાઈટ ઓકે પછી માટે બાકી રાખો માટેથી આ ચેપ્ટર મહિના કંઈ કાઉન્સ છે વાઈડ વળી પર પછી શીખીએ સો નેક્સ્ટ થિંગ ઇઝ is specific latent heat or simply latent heat. Nobody says the word specific. Do you already know what is latent heat? Or not? MSP Manan Dev? Are you sure? Let me give you explanation first. I would just say, what do you meaning of
it? Is the theory.
Okay, let's say that you take some water in an open vessel, open, and you start heating it. And let's say starting it was at room temperature, for example, 30 degrees Celsius. 30 degrees Celsius at room temperature. Right? Which is season? Mass season? Okay. Right? In this season, if you don't have the AC, then the room temperature will be well beyond 35. But what the important time is 36, 37, 32. Never mind. So let's say it is 30 degrees and you start heating it. So it will increase up to 200. Okay? This is only change in temperature, no change in phase, phase or state. State samajh pade? Not a liquid gas or phase, right? From the word is actually phase. So if your temperature will change, right? Okay, there will be some evaporation, you will throw. Ultimately, when it is 100 degrees Celsius, the water starts to boil. Now when it starts to boil, what's going to happen is that this temperature will not change. Fixed is 20%. The temperature will not change. Okay, listen to this carefully. What happens is, you are supplying heat, temperature has become 100. Now you know that water boils at 100 degrees. Okay, so under standard conditions of 180 temperature and all that, you cannot have water at 100.1 degrees Celsius, for example. How possible that is? At 101 degrees Celsius, 100.1 degrees Celsius and 180 m pressure, H2O. Always take which phase? The gaseous phase, not the liquid phase. At 100 degree Celsius, it will get converted into gases. Okay. So, try to. I think you put a thermometer. Okay, clamp it. What you notice is that the water, while it's boiling, this temperature will remain fixed at 100 degrees Celsius. The temperature will not increase at 100 to 100 degrees Celsius. Meanwhile, the water will be boiling, 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 boiling. Gradually, as the water boils, the amount will decrease. Okay. So, what does this mean? Is that when the water boils, while the water is boiling at this 180 atm pressure, the temperature will not go beyond 100. 1300 will increase by that, but then the temperature will not go beyond 100 until all water goes into gaseous, until all water goes into the gas. Basically, what this means is until all the liquid gets converted into gas, that's the temperature 90. It will remain fixed. Another example. Suppose you take ice, okay, some ice cubes, and let's say you put a thermometer in it, and the temperature right now is in minus 5 degrees. Move the room to empty. What's going to happen? You will start getting hotter, that is from minus 5, you get minus 4, minus 3, blah, 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 blah. It will come to 0. And you know, beyond 0, you cannot have ice. It should melt. So while it starts to melt, temperature will remain fixed at 0 degrees. What should you think? While the ice is melting. Did you understand what I am saying? Ultimately, when all ice melts, after all ice melt, that is all the H2O is now converted into which phase? Liquid. Aqua phase changes in it. What is called phase change? Phase change means it goes from one phase to another. Right? So it changes from solid to liquid. Until all of that happens, temperature will not change. So after all ice melts, temperature starts increasing once again. Temperature starts increasing. Did you understand this? Outside, this is a fact. Okay, so this is what actually is surprising. And NMR data words say, why surprising? Think about it. When you heat it, so if you heat, temperature should definitely increase. But you know you. That is, until all the water goes into gaseous phase, temperature remains same. Was it? Just like that, until all ice melts, temperature sticks to zero. It will not increase. So what is going on really? Here, is it not getting heat from outside? It is getting heat from outside. Temperature going to every day, was going to it. But it does not increase during that time. You get what I am saying? Pella I was from minus 5 to 0. But 0 for fixed thing. Put you. Until all the ice melts. Why is 0 thing? Water put it. So, what's going on? Is that when heat is supplied here, that heat can do two things. This gap. The heat can do two things. One, it can raise temperature. We all know. The second thing is that it can change phase, that is, it can change the substance from solid to liquid or from liquid to gas. Clear? So what are the two things heat can do?
Change
the temperature. Okay, we talk about MS delta T. What that telling you is when you supply heat, temperature will change, increase. And the second thing is it can change phase. That is from solid to liquid or liquid to gas. And that is where we have something interesting, is that until all the phases change, until all water's phase changes, the temperature does not rise. it would easily make something from there. We know that water boiling point is 100 degrees. You know, matlab at 100.01 even, at this temperature, at 180 atm pressure, can water be liquid phase? No. Can it temperature be higher than this phase? So where does that energy go? After some time, gas will burn it. Bita ase. What happened? So you see, it will not go away. The temperature will not go away. The bill will not come. Where did the energy go? It is used to convert the liquid molecules to gaseous phase. For oxygen, I'm sure you know that in liquid, the molecules are a little bit close, right? And they do have some attraction. So this energy is used to break that attraction and separate each other. From liquid state, if they break the attraction and they go free, then it will enter which phase? The gaseous. What is it? The energy that you get, it is used to break the attraction of solid molecules. So from ice, it will melt, and the attraction breaks, they become a little loose, they go slightly away from each other. And from solid, you get into the gases. Liquid state. Clear? Sure? So that's where the energy is going. So people actually call it heater. I later on go out to me into the hypothesis. Heater. Where someone put a camp heater? Because people were expecting if you heat it, temperature should continuously increase. But at some point it just stops increasing. And so energy to the idea, that is heat is upright, but temperature is not rising. So people thought, okay, where is this heat hiding? Can do this. So they will change of thing. Understood? Okay, how are you proper definition? Do you realize that the heat required to melt some amount of ice or heat required to boil some amount of water should follow this relation Q proportional to M? What does that mean? 1 gram ice flow, then you melt karama, what's the heat flow, what's the energy? 1 kg ice flow, then you melt karama, what's the energy? That is basically the heat required to melt should be proportional to M. Same thing for boiling water or same thing for any other liquid. Clear? So when we remove proportionality, we should get a and that constant is L. We write it as L. This L is nothing but specific chapter. Why am I calling it specific? Specific meaning is like a per unit mass. Whenever anything is specific, it is always per unit mass. A per unit mass is different. So, this logo is not the same. Right? People will write later. One way, after some reason, it is specific later. Okay? So, when we remove the proportionality, we get a constant. This L. Right? So, where L is called specific later of that material. Of the material for phase change. It is called specific latent heat of the material for phase change. Now it depends which phase change it is. Melting or the fusion here. Okay? Boiling or the boiling. Okay, latent heat for evaporation or latent heat for boiling. Well, so that is Q equal to M. Units of the divide L equal to Q by M. Q for joule energy. Q whatever divided by mass. So joule per kg. Clear? What the time?
7 minutes
to go. Okay. This might often, you know, we write 2, LB, that is latent heat of vaporization, and LF, that is latent heat of fusion. Now, two things are very simple actually, but let me just put it here so that nobody ever gets confused. So when you are going from solid to liquid, obviously heat is absorbed, right? That is Q is greater than 0, yes or no? Sure, that makes sense. And similarly, when you are going from liquid to gas, you have Q is greater than 0, this is common, right? Okay, undo. If you are going from liquid to solid, it means the substance is releasing energy. When will water become ice? When you supply energy? Think about it. If there is water and you supply energy, will it become ice? No. So when you remove energy, that's what a refrigerator does. When you remove energy, then water will become ice. So when you want to go from liquid to solid, and when you want to go from gas to liquid, in these cases you are going to get Q is less than 1. Not so how simple is it, but that's the way I confuse it as well. Clear? What are these things? Take sublimation in mind. Sublimation. Am I the energy absorbed? Okay, but we rarely need it, so I'm not ready. Okay, but the text of my fine, so this is KTL. Day later heat allowed for vaporization means what going from liquid to gas, and for fusion that is going from solid to liquid. Right? Okay, again, an important sentence is that L depends on material. It depends on material and actually also depends on pressure. It depends on material and pressure. But if pressure order part is generally going to see business other, but is independent of mass. But is independent of mass of substance. Jim will small as mass. Specific was the one, go with the specific. It is always independent of mass. Okay. So that's what we got here. Right? Pressure is to change the equipment. Suppose you think that you want to boil water when the pressure is very high. So when the liquid we try to convert to gas, there is pressure na karne jane, it will get opposite. Do you know that if somehow you could do this next, you take some liquid and here is a lid and if again comes pipe jump in after the air card it off, that if you make vacuum here then water will start boiling. You know that? Next. Do you know that water boils at low temperature if pressure is less? When you go to hilltops, let's say go to Shimla for example, it's quite high. There, the boiling point of water will not be 100 degrees Celsius, it will be less because the pressure over there, atmospheric pressure, is less. Okay. Pressure does play a part when you talk about vaporization or evaporation, boiling. So, when the pressure is less, the value of air will also be less. Why so? Because the pressure from outside is going to try to push the molecules back. Fine, so here we have a journal, but rarely ever we need it. Anyway, okay. I'll take you to heat capacity and return. Okay, come to the top. Okay, calculate what is the place. Well, I'm okay, simple question. I first. Let's go to exercise. Yes. Here it is. Question 12 from exercise. Question 12 from the exercise. A 10 kilowatt drilling machine used to drill a bore with gold in a small aluminium block of mass 8 kg. Suppose this block. Here the drilling machine the hole around. Okay, so obviously because of friction there will be a lot of heat generated. Okay, and mass energy. How much is the mass? 8 kg. How much is the rise temperature of the block in how much time? 2.5 minutes. Okay, assuming 50% of power is used up in heating the machine itself or lost to the surroundings. Okay, so what does this mean? Saying that whatever this drill machine gives power, 50% of that is lost. But what, where will the remaining 50% go? It will heat the block. Understood? Yes or no? So that friction is going to heat up this. Okay, so total energy is 50% of the lost. But block will still get 50%. Clear? So do you agree that power received by block, okay, power received by block is E, E for power, equal to 50% of 10 kilowatt. 50% loss, how much remaining? 50%, that is equal to block. As of now, 50% of 10 kilowatt is nothing but 5 kilowatt. Okay, what is the power? Power and energy, energy transfer per unit time. Yes or no? Sure, you can say energy transfer per unit time or work done per unit time. Work done is energy transfer. So do you agree that here I can write heat supplied per unit time? Heat is nothing but energy. Correct? Is this fine? Heat supplied per unit time. Okay? Right, so we will use it. What's the question? How much is the rise in temperature of the block in 2.5 minutes? Find the current rise in temperature. What will you take? How am I delta T is allowed? Q equal to MS delta T. So therefore, M small s specific heat delta T upon T equal to 5 into 10 raised to 3. Understood? SI unit what? So 5 into 10 raised to 3. How is it going? Delta T. So delta T equal to 5 into 10 raised to 3 equals small t. Small t was the time. In how much time? 2.5 minutes. But SI unit is around 2.5 to 60. Okay? Okay or not okay? Divided by mass. What mass? 8 kg. Okay. There divided by S. S that is aluminium specific heat. Aluminium specific heat. How much? 0.59. Units will check. 0.91 into kai se units hote joule per gram per kelvin. See, if s is 0.91 joule per gram per kelvin, it is same as kilo joule per kilogram per kelvin. Here I 1000 and then I 1000 here the top. Okay, so SI unit only, no problem. Okay, just put the value. Thank you, Guru. We can divide it for another thing. It's a very good lesson. Right? Check the answer. Okay, ultimately this will be Kelvin or Celsius. We call it M delta T. Delta T in Kelvin or delta T in Celsius are both same. Right? Okay. One of this one.